numbers. Big numbers. 100-minute bag, that's a big number. Big numbers. Big numbers. Whole team count it, that's a big number.
Hey, foreign cars, foreign.
Hello, everybody. I'm Jonathan Coachman, and this is Super Bowl Sunday on EA Sports. Up next, we've got what should be a great matchup between the New England Patriots and the Dallas Cowboys. Kickoff now just moments away. It is finally time to crown a champion, as I'll hand it over to the two men who will call the action, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, we are pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Tonight, it's all on the line. We play for the Lombardi Trophy, as it'll be the AFC champion New England Patriots taking on the NFC champions, the Dallas Cowboys. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden, and it is our extreme privilege to be on hand for the Super Bowl. And I can't help but look down on this field, partner, and think about the history of this game and all the great players, all the great teams that have stood on the field for this moment. So special.
This game is so historic that while we call it the Super Bowl now, that wasn't even the name of the first couple. It was the AFL-NFL World Championship game before the Super Bowl really took hold. And think about the Green Bay Packers winning the first two that got us kicked off and started towards where we are today.
And with the whole world watching, at the end of this game, at the end of tonight, one of these two sides, they get to etch their name in NFL immortality.
No doubt about it. They hold up the ultimate symbol of victory in this league, the Lombardi Trophy.
Is finally set, and here we go. Super Bowl 57 is underway. This will be taken in at the one. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. So here are the Cowboys now ready to go on offense for the first time. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback.
And I liked what his head coach told us about him this week, that no matter what happens, whether he throws seven interceptions or seven touchdown passes, he's the same assertive leader in the huddle on each and every play. He can throw the seven interceptions, just blame the football, blame anything else, and still carry himself like he is the man.
It's like you, assertive in our production meetings.
Well, especially when we're talking about ordering dinner, ordering some
snacks. I was just going to say.
That's where I go.
Just what you want on a first down run, call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. On second down, McCaffrey. And that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. Call it a loss of 6 on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down.
We all have habits. We can be somewhat predictable. And you know me pretty well on second down and short. What I like to say?
Play action.
Yeah, without a doubt. I thought that was a great spot to call it. Instead, didn't go their way, did it?
No, defense sold out for the run. Worked out well. An early tough test on the opening drive. This is third and 8. Ambrose now from the gun. He'll throw. Got a man. It's Ross. Complete. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. And even 30 yards on a play that began back at the 30.
Brandon, we've both been around the game long enough that we know that in pregame, defenses are pretty amped up, aren't they? I mean, they're pounding lockers and they can't wait to get out there. But when you hit them with some big pass plays early, it takes the starch right out of them.
So the big play moves them all the way across midfield to the 40 now for first and 10. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. The ball's out. McCaffrey lost it. And it's picked up by the Patriots. And he's over the line and into the end zone for a Patriots score. Striking first in any game is very important, but on this stage, the biggest of stages in the Super Bowl, that's huge.
You fully expect the other team to battle all the way through, but when you're the one setting the pace, jumping out in front, that has to feel great for the entire organization.
Extra point right down the middle, and that makes the score 7-0. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. This fielded at the 2. And he'll take this across the 25, couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. Out comes Christian McCaffrey with the rest of the offense. He's probably a little angry at himself. It was his fumble, obviously, a moment ago that led to the scoop and score touchdown that has him down early.
And now we find out about the psychology aspect of being a coach. Because when you have a guy that's just happened, some people want to take him out of the game immediately. Others say, you know something? Let's feed him the ball again next series and see if he's going to be able to atone for it. Let's see what they decide to do.
Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Off play action. Ambrose. They complete it to Hill. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys like we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs as we just saw there.
So into Pats territory now. Here's 1st and 10 at the 42-yard line. Ambrose. Operating from the gun. He's going to air it out for Dorsett. And that is going to be pulled in one-handed. Wow. 36 yards on the play. Well, make that now 2 completions for him on this drive. And these aren't ordinary completions. They're big ones.
Yeah, these are the types that make a secondary talk to each other and not in a good way. Oftentimes pointing fingers. Hey, who's got him? Someone cover him. That type of indecision can open up even more big plays.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's 1st and goal. Now Ambrose. From the gun, he'll throw. And he is into the end zone for a Cowboy touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. Well, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, but his top 2 options were not available on that throw, so he went the safe route. Worked out pretty well.
It was like you were in the pocket. How about you going through the progressions like that? But a lot of offenses say touchdown to check down. Look downfield first, bring it back to the line of scrimmage. Not easy for a rookie to do. Oftentimes they get one look, and they make their decision off of that. He went through 3. That was impressive.
So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. So here come the Patriots getting ready on offense. They'll be led out by their 6'5 quarterback out of North Dakota State. It's Carson Wentz.
He didn't have as many throws or plays in college as many of the quarterbacks that were coming out in the draft, but he maximized what he had. Ended up winning 2 national championships as a starting quarterback at North Dakota State.
They'll run. This is Gus Edwards. He'll have a first down past the 40. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. Offense. That's a good chunk of yardage. It's going to be canceled out.
And we always talk about hidden yardage in a game. That's going to count as that because now it doesn't go on the books. But now they have to make that up again, don't they?
From the gun, they run with Ware. That's a gain of 6 on the first down run.
I can't help it. Every time I see Eric Berry make a play, as we just saw him make a tackle there, I just want to stand up and applaud.
Because he went to Tennessee like you?
Well, that doesn't hurt one bit, but how about the comeback? I mean, he came back from beating cancer.
And that's caught inside the 30. It's a big play there for the Patriots. And even 50 yards.
But we spent a lot of time exalting the offensive masterminds in this game, right? They draw up these beautiful plays. It looks so perfect up on the board. But occasionally, sometimes you just say, throw it up and let him go get it. How about that play?
First carry now for Gus Edwards.
And only able to muster a couple down to about the 27.
2 yards that time. A stark contrast from the big chunk on the previous play.
And let's give you a look here at the New England offense.
And a big key is going to be how can these wideouts create separation from the defensive backs? Because we've seen some early success in the passing game in this one, and that's going to need to continue.
And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's probably a pretty good sign here on the opening drive if your guys from the secondary are coming up and spilling things in the backfield.
How about the adrenaline and aggressiveness that led his eyes to the backfield?
And he's in. Touchdown, Patriots. Tyler Boyd, 27 yards. And the Patriots have taken the lead. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You've got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, when I'd be in practice sessions and I'd hear 9 from the receivers, that meant fly route, go. Look out. That was the 9, and he just kept going all the way into the end zone for the touchdown.
Extra point splits the uprights, and that makes the score 14-7. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They trail early on in this Super Bowl as they come up 1st and 10. The drive begins with a run by McCaffrey. He'll have a 1st down past the 40. 30, the 20, 10, touchdown, Cowboys! Christian McCaffrey, his 2nd touchdown of this Super Bowl, as they are an extra point away now from tying this football game. Not a whole lot to recap on that drive. Just 1 play, 75 yards to the house.
Yeah, it's a long way to go. And remember, rarely is it a straight line 75 yards, too. Got to have a little extra in there. So whatever the final number is, a well-deserved seat on the bench, a little oxygen if he wants it as well.
Extra point up and good by Bailey. And we are tied at 14. One of the shortest drives you'll ever see. 1 play, 75 yards, 6 points. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And Charles, the way touchdowns have come so fast and furious for both sides in this thing, it's starting to feel a little bit more like maybe a tennis match than a football game.
Yeah, I like your description.
He rifles one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. These two teams all tied after one. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And coming off a 1-play drive that was so deflating for the defense, what's their mentality? How do they rally here and stop this offense?
Well, hopefully there's some determination that sets in, because if they weren't ready to go on the last one, give all the credit to the offensive guys for getting it done, but to allow a run of that length, that's just not being prepared. So now, are they determined? Are they ready to read their keys and make the proper plays?
And we'll see how determined they are.
Look at me. Go on.
Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that's going to make it third down and less than a yard.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid gain. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains.
Well, that last run makes this a 100-yard night. I've loved the way he's hit the holes. He's been quick. He's been decisive. And he's been a whole lot of fun to watch.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Back to throw. Ambrose, he'll take a shot for the... And oh, it'll be intercepted. Picked off by Stephon Gilmore. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
He's had a fantastic rookie season, made a lot of lovely throws, but that wasn't one of them.
Well, we got to give him one, don't we? I mean, with the year he's having, a lot easier for he and his teammates to accept that throw. Because for the most part, what they've seen, it's been pretty sensational.
Now it looks like we've got a Patriot down, slow to get up. We'll check on his status when we get back. A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11. Now Wentz. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long way out there, but it'll be third down.
By the way, I got to apologize because I just realized for about the last 4 or 5 plays, I'm eking over into your territory up here in the booth. My bad. I'm going to get back over to my spot.
Yeah, we're not talking about our on-air commentary. I mean, what is all this extra paper? I mean, this is unusual for you.
My bad.
Normally, you run a really tight ship. What's going on here?
Just like that incomplete pass, I'm going to try to tighten things up here for this next play.
Running on first down with Ware. Nowhere to go that time. He maybe got a yard up to the 40.
And this is why aggressive defensive coordinators love to blitz. It wreaks havoc because they end up taking their attention to the blitzers, freed up the D lineman to make the play.
On second and 9, Wentz. And his throw's going to be incomplete. After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on 3rd and 9. Play action. Now Wentz. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 48. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you...
And this is caught for a Cowboy touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 42 yards as his guys are able to regain the lead.
I'll let you do the analysis, partner, but with every touchdown pass this young quarterback throws and with the success that his team has had, I just continue to be more and more impressed.
Let's both do the analysis. Impressed, aren't we both?
Yeah.
I mean, and why shouldn't we be? We've seen him improve throughout the year. We've seen him settle in now, and you can see the confidence of the team has grown. His confidence has grown. I think that everyone around this guy feels good about what they've seen. And it's also safe for him when he's driving home to turn on Sports Talk Radio. He's okay.
Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Time for Tyler Boyd and the rest of the offense to take over now. He's been good so far to this point in the second quarter. Need to get him even more involved, maybe?
I would agree with that. Definitely. Yeah, it's not even a question for me. The way he's playing, he's doing a nice job. Increase things. More touches, more opportunities. Maybe that can reverse things on the scoreboard for them.
They'll try to ratchet things up then maybe here in the second quarter. They'll run with Edwards here to begin the drive. Tackle made by the third-round pick out of Louisiana, Tracy Walker.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size and these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. It'll be third down. Two minutes on the clock in the second quarter of this Super Bowl. Coming up in a couple of minutes, we'll get you to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. The coach will have stats and scores from earlier today in the NFL. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts. So as they take it over, we step aside. On fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on to punt. This is taken at the 15. Officially, that'll go as a 52-yard punt. Not too shabby. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. Now here's the signal caller getting ready to lead this offense again. And they must have seen something leading up to this one that said, hey, we're going to be able to go deep because they've gone deep with a lot of success.
And pick your phrase, pick your code words, your buzzwords, whatever, vertical stretch, deep passes, go routes, right? What's that route you love? What's that route you love?
Four verts.
Four verts. All of it working because they're able to find ways to get deep and for him to show off that big, big arm.
We see some of that big arm right here. He has been great. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And they work this well upfield across the 45. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
Big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Looking to throw. Ambrose rolling to his right. He'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40. 13 yards and a first down, Cowboys.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. But sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Here's Ambrose. Off the play fake. And going deep for Hill. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Cowboys. Tyreek Hill. His second touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further.
He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
Now Bailey to tack on the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. The drive there only spanning three plays. And it culminates in a Dallas touchdown. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken at the three. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. The Pats at the line, ready to go. And you're under a minute to go in the half, a first half that hasn't been particularly kind to you. How do you think they'll play this?
Well, I think the smart approach is to run out the clock, lick your wounds at the half, and see if you can come up with a strategy to play better in the second. But it's also something to challenge in your offense right here. You know, hey, guys, you help dig this hole. See if you can get us out of it a little bit before the half runs out. Let's go make some plays.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Completes it to Lee. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds to go in the first half. From the 32 now, here's first and 10.
I'm coming. Check. Lucky.
From the gun, it's Wins. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. This is Ware. And they'll go backwards here, losing yardage to the 14. The Patriots will take their third and final timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half. To throw again on second down, Wentz. He's got this to his running back, Spencer Ware. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Call it a gain of 5, and that's going to lead to a third down.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. What a season this has been. Hard to believe it ends tonight, as we'll get back to you guys for the second half of this Super Bowl in just a moment. It's been a tremendous season of football, but it's not over yet. One half remains to decide who will stand on the podium with the Vince Lombardi Trophy. And to call the second half, here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. These two teams sat through a longer than usual 30-minute wait, but we're back in action here in this Super Bowl. It's a short kick, taking it to 15. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
and I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
But this
is
a real,
I'm doing it though. This is a really important drive, and we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half too, and they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. It's a loss of four on the first down play.
But these guys are going to chop into that deficit. They got to do a much better job in the run game. Caught behind the line of scrimmage, no yardage will be found.
Throwing on second and 14. Wentz. Tyler Boyd, the former Pitt Panther, was the target. And it's third down.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Shotgun now for Wentz. He's going to float this one deep right side. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield. And look, it doesn't matter whether you're playing man or zone. Eventually, that becomes man on man. And you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
Here's Matt Bosher now as he'll kick it away for the second time. We'll call that a 49-yard punt, but a net of just 39 following the 10-yard return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Tyreek Hill making his way back out towards the huddle. And I know that they've double-teamed him a couple times, but not a ton. Whatever they're doing isn't working. He's up over 100 yards. We'll see how they adjust.
And when they do that, they weaken their defense in other places as well. And how many times have we done games where we've seen a guy have a big game like this? But it's usually not by himself, is it?
Right.
Usually it opens it up for other people to have big games as well.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Back to throw. Ambrose connects here with a tight end, Blake Jarwin. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? And it sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. So into Pat's territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 46. McCaffrey. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Yeah.
Now Ambrose to throw. Looking to throw on second down. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. Give him 9 yards on the second down screen play.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Last catch nearly got him a first, but it did not, and they'll try to convert on third and inches. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. That good for 19 and a first down.
Now this is an example of breaking down a defense, because a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
Check 55 to the ball. I'm coming.
the red zone now. They'll look to throw. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked out and incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
They'll run with McCaffrey. And he'll get four there, down to about the 12-yard line.
That's it, baby. Third quarter and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Ambrose now operating from the gun. And able to find Dorsett. His second catch in the Super Bowl, and it's good enough for a first down. Well, they've had a great, impressive drive going here, and that pickup ensures the drive continues.
And not only do you continue the drive, which is demoralizing for the guys on the defensive side of the ball right now, but you make your own defense happy. They're able to get a little more rest over on the sidelines while this one continues downfield.
8-3. Recon, 132 fighter.
Kill. Bam.
Check safety.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further.
Still plenty of time left in the game, but now starting to pull away a little bit. Get some breathing room with that one.
And I don't want people to think that NFL locker rooms are cookie cutter, that everyone's saying the exact same thing in every situation. But I do know that all 32 teams have an emphasis on starting fast. Game, you know, second half, no matter what. With those first 5 minutes, first three, whatever. This was a big score to start the second half.
Bailey got the extra point, and the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Now the Patriots offense, they work their way back out onto the field. They trail here by 24 points. Got to get going soon, you'd have to think, as they come up first and 10. They fake the give. Now wins. He gets this one to Boyd. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 17 yards there for the Patriots as they've got themselves a first down.
And another thing that makes a comeback route really effective is that oftentimes after you've made the initial move, receivers breaking away from the defensive back, and that makes it a really tough play to defend. A nice chunk of yardage picked up there.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. We have not seen a whole lot of wide open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
And they've held them in check on the scoreboard. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Wentz now to throw. Wide open receiver complete. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. A pickup of 27. And they pick up the first down in the process. Try to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. On first down, Ware, and he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. One quarter remains here in the Super Bowl. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Working from the gun, Wentz. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. The reception good for seven. It's third down. You got the big lead defensively, willing to give them that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling. Tackle them after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And boy, he is very close to a first down, but from where they're spotting that football, he's going to be a foot or so short. Call it a one-yard gain on the play, and that'll bring up fourth down.
One hallmark of good defenses is understanding the game, understanding positioning, and tackling immediately in the secondary after catches. I think we just saw that on display right there.
Got to him before he ever had a chance to think about turning it upfield. Wentz to throw for it on fourth. He's got his man, Boyd. And he gets this down to the 18. Good enough for a first down. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Edwards now on first and 10. Able to fight for about 4 yards there to the 13.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball in this drive and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short game. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
To throw on second and 6. Wentz. Oh, he's got a man wide open. Complete. The Patriot passing game is rolling. They've got another first down. They'll look to run with Edwards. They're able to get a couple here, but won't get across the plane as they stop him right around the one.
Do you think after that last run, they're thinking to themselves, we had to wait all day to play this night game, and we're still not able to run the ball the way we want to?
Yeah, this defense, they've risen to the challenge all evening long. Again, it'll be Edwards. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, and it'll set up third down. This linebacking core, they've done a good job of keeping that running game in check, haven't they?
They certainly have, and what they'll also do when this game is over is thank the guys up front, the big defensive line, because they've kept them clean, so to speak, not letting blockers get to them, allowing them to run to the football and keep that running game bottled up.
This Cowboy defense trying to hold them out of the end zone. They've run it to third and goal. They'll try and run. Edwards. And he is in. Touchdown, New England. Taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Patriots get a score closer.
I'm not sure win-win is the proper term here, but it certainly felt like it. They got the touchdown they needed, but if I'm on the defensive side of the ball, okay, you got the touchdown, but it sure took you a long time.
Yeah, because offensively there, you're probably hoping for a 1-5 play drive. That one ate up a little more time than they were hoping.
You're exactly right, and if you have that 1-5 play drive, you actually build up momentum and even more hope. When they had to slog their way downfield, they got the touchdown, but it's almost like, yeah, you know.
Doesn't feel right.
Exactly.
Point after, right down the middle. And that will get them one closer. So that drive spans 13 plays. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Two scores down, 3 timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. A scramble for it. I think the Patriots may have got it. They did. Well, that certainly makes things more interesting. You get the score, then you get the onside kick. A little uphill battle still, but a start.
It's not mission accomplished, but the plan is working. They are in a great spot right now, and the best part, they put the defense right back up.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked by Tracy Walker. And he will score. Touchdown, Cowboys. And that one will pretty much erase any hopes of a fourth quarter comeback.
With emphasis, interception, return for touchdown. Door closed, locked, reinforced.
Extra point try by Bailey. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns at 21 points. A heck of a play there defensively, getting the interception, navigating his way into the end zone for the touchdown. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. This will be taken in at the 1. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in and now you're not going to pull loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
That'll be a New England first down, a gain of 12. So the Patriots with a football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And now a throw here secured by his running back out of the backfield. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Throwing his Wentz. He completes it to Boyd.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen, because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup for a first down.
Throwing again on second down. Wentz, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. On play action, Wentz. He's going to let it fly. Oh, he almost intercepted it. They're just forcing it into too many tough spots. That was almost a fourth pick of the game. And now fourth down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. If they're going to have a shot in this Super Bowl, they're going to need this one on fourth down. Wentz going to go on fourth down. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. No reason not to try it there. And they do indeed convert on fourth. He's got his man on the crossing route. And they're going to be set up down around the 15-yard line. The end result, 21 yards. Now Wentz. And that's going to be caught for a Patriot touchdown. Dallas Goedert there to make the grab. And the Patriots make some inroads here on that deficit. And he is a reliable target. They like to get him involved. They got him involved there for the score.
And they should. He's a very good player. Remember, they can use him in certain positions, so many different spots, and he usually comes through for them.
Extra point attempt to come here. And the lead will be cut down to 14. So that one, an 8-play drive, it spans 75 yards. And it's finished off by a Pats touchdown. And this is going to be recovered by the hand seam. And that should just about put a capper on this one. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. And that is caught. Touchdown, Cowboys. Touchdown. Tyreek Hill with his third touchdown of this Super Bowl. And the Cowboys, they push out in front further. He has really settled in throwing the football, and that touchdown here in the fourth quarter gives him a pretty comfortable cushion.
He may be a rookie,
but he's playing like fourth quarter, and the QBing is easy. How about this guy? Youngster, not worried about anything, just cutting it loose and having fun.
And a pause in the action because the booth, they see something that they want to take another peek at to find out if this was a touchdown or not. Monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for, and this touchdown will count. Here's Bailey now for the extra point. And the lead now to three touchdowns at 21 points. Bailey now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is fielded at the goal line. And not a bad return. Here he gets it out to the 25-yard line. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?" He just waved a hand like, "Who cares? Let's
make
get out of here and do something some other time." But some teams like to do something at the end to feel a little bit better as they continue to move forward.
Yeah, I probably just want to put this one behind them. 18 big yards on that one, and a New England first down. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
That's into the hands of Edwards. Able to corral him right at the midfield stripe following that sparkling display of footwork we saw. Now the Patriots going to use one of their timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth. Able to get seven on that first down pass play. Second and three. And he finds Spencer Ware complete. And this time he's able to take it down to the 42. Now the Patriots will use the second of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in the game. Throwing on first is Wentz. That's caught by Ware. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. That first down completion only netted him three. Second and seven. Again, they'll throw with Wentz. This one caught by Lee. And now here comes their final timeout. As they take it with eight ticks remaining. Wentz going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's hit on all five of his pass attempts on his drive so far. Throwing now is Wentz. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. After the incomplete pass here now is second and 10. One final try now for Wentz. Dumps that off to Ware. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. And the Dallas Cowboys will hoist the Lombardi Trophy. They are the kings of the NFL. For the victors getting to hoist that Lombardi Trophy, you know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. What a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gaudin signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.